Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. Today again we are going to discuss one more very interesting technique, that is shortcut method to find total number of factors. So this is again a very common type of question asking for total number of factors for some big number. So how do we find out the total number of factors in a less time? That is what we are going to discuss today. Okay, so before that, let me explain what is factors, then we will understand the technique easily. So what is factor? So factor means, for example, let me take 8. What are the factors of 8? We have factor is nothing but a number which divides the given number exactly, means with the remainder 0. So what are the number divides 8? Then 1 divides, 2 divides, 4 divides and 8 divides, that's it, right? So we can say there are total 4 factors we have for 8. So always remember the number 8 is a maximum factor for 8. That is, always the maximum factor for the given number is the number itself. Okay. Now one more thing you need to understand here is about prime factor. What is prime factor? Prime factors means the number which is factor also and prime also. If you observe, out of these 4, there is only one number which is a prime factor. So 2 is a prime factor of 8. So it is prime number and also factor. Okay. Now how do I find out total number of factors when there is big number given? Okay, so before going to big number, let me explain the technique with some simple number, then we will apply the technique for the bigger number. Okay, so let me take one simple number, let's say 20. I want to find out total number of factors that 20 has. So what I will do, if it is a simple number, I simply list out. So instead of listing out here, what you can do is split 20 in terms of prime factors. That is, 20 can be written as 2 into 10. 2 into 10 is nothing but 2 into 2 into 5. So I am converting 20 into a prime factor, so that is nothing but 2 square into 5 power 1. Okay, so once you convert the given number into this form, what you have to observe is the power of these prime factors. So what is the power of 2 here? 2. Add 1 to it. What is the power of 5 here? 1. Add 1 to it. So now multiply these number. What is 2 plus 1? It is 3. What is 1 plus 1? It is 2. 3 into 2 is 6. The total number of factors that 20 has is 6. So how we get 6 here? Why we have to add 1? I know most of you have this doubt, so I'll clarify in a while. So just understand, one more time I'm explaining the technique. First, always convert the given number into a prime factor form and see the power, and add 1 to each power and multiply that product, which you will get the total number of factors of given number. Okay, so now you might be wondering why I am adding 1 to it here. So why I am adding means, see, 2 square means 2 power 1 and 2 power 2, 5 power 1, right? So here also you need to consider one more factor which divides 20 is 2 power 0 and 5 power 0. This is also one of the combination which divides 20, which is nothing but 1. 2 power 0 is 1, 5 power 0 is also 1. So you have to consider these two also. So that is why we are adding 1 in each cases. So 5 power 1, only one number was there, so I added 1, that is 5 power 0. 2 power 1 and 2 power 2, two numbers are there. So I'm adding one more number, that is 2 power 0, that's why plus 1. Okay. So this is what will give you total number of factors. Okay. Now let's see one more example here. One more simple example only I'm going to take now. So let's say 50. I want to find out total number of factors that 50 has. So how do you write? First step is converting 50 into a prime factor form. How do you convert 5 into 10? So 5 into 10 can be written as 2 into 5. So it is nothing but 5 square into 2 to the power of 1. So what I told is, once you convert into a prime factor form, take the power and add 1 to each of the powers. So first power is 2, adding 1. Second one power is 1, adding 1. So how much it is? 3. This is 2. So how much? It is 6. So the answer is 6 now. So that is number of total number of factors for 50 is 6. That is, if you list out also, because 50 is a small number, you can list out here 1, 2, 5, 10, 25, 50. So if you observe, there are 6 numbers which divides 50. If it is a small number, you can list out like this, but if it is a bigger number, it is very difficult and time consuming process. That's why we are following this method. Okay, let me take some bigger number and show you. So let me take 200. How many total number of factors this 200 has? So 200, we can write it as 20 into 10. 20, we can write it as 5 into 4. 4 again, I am writing in terms of 2 because we want to convert this into a prime factor form. And 10 again, we can write it in the form of 2 and 5. So finally, 2 cube into 5 square. 2 cube into 5 square we got in the prime factor form. So now what is the next step? Just go with the power and add 1 to each of the power. So first power is 3, adding 1. Second power is 2, adding 1. So 3 plus 1 is 4, 2 plus 1 is 3. So 4 into 3 is 12. So total number of factors of 200 are 20. Okay. Now, one more example, just for the practice. 300, how many factors, 300 will have? So 300, how do you convert? 30 into 10. Again, 30 can be written as 5 into 6. 5 into 6 is 2 into 3. Again, 2 into 5 for 10. So write it in the form of powers. So 2 square into 3 into 5 square. So nothing means there will be one power. So 3 into 2 into 3. How much? 3 into 3, 9. 9 into 2 is 18. There are 18 factors for 300. Got it? So this is how we can easily find out the number of factors. So only thing is, you have to convert that into a prime factor form and then add 1 to each of the power so that you will be getting the total number of factor or divisors of the given number. Okay, so now let's see some examples how these kind of questions are given in the exam. So first question is, find the total number of factors of n. So what is n here? N is 2 cube into 5 square. So if you remember, just now we did that 2 cube into 5 square. So that's why I'm going to change it a little bit. So let's say 2 to the power of 5 into 5 cube. So tell me, what is the total number of factors this number will have? So it's very simple. You already have in the prime factor form. Just you need to add 1 to the power here. 5 plus 1 is 6. 3 plus 1 is 4. 6 fours are 24. So this n will have 24 factors. Got it? So sometimes they give in this form, so that time it will be very easy. Even though if they have not given in this form, you can always convert in the form of prime factors. Once you get the prime factors powers, you can just add 1 to each of the power and get the, product. The product is nothing but the total number of factors. Okay. Let's take one more example here. Let me read out the question. What are the total number of divisors of 600, including 1 and 600? So don't worry about this statement. So let's find out total number of factors this 600 will have. So 600, how do you write? 6 into 100. 6 can be written as 2 into 3. 100 can be written as 25 into 4. 25 can be written as 5 square. 4 can be written as 2 square. So now what will be the total power of 2? It is 3, 2 cube into 3 into 5 square. So nothing means 1 will be there. So now 3 plus 1 is 4, 1 plus 1 is 2, and 2 plus 1 is 3. So 4 3s are 12, 12 2s are 24. So 600 will have 24 factors. So the answer here is 24. So then you might be wondering, then what is this statement is? Including 1 and 600 means total factors they are asking here. Instead of writing only total number of division, to make you confused, they will give these kind of statement. But don't worry, including 1 and 600. 1 is also a factor of 600. 600 is also a factor of 600, as I told you earlier. So the maximum factor for given number is the number itself. So 600 is also a factor. Okay. So this is one of the question. So let me give you one more question here. How many divisors, including 1 but excluding 1000, are there for number 1000. So again they are asking, you know, the total number of factors, but here you have to observe is we have to exclude the 1000, the maximum factor of this number we have to exclude. Before that, let us find out first total number of factors. So you know already what to do to find out the total number of factors. So this you have to convert into prime factor. So what is the prime factor of this? See, if you get very big number and if you are, you know, finding difficult in writing this way directly, what you can do is you can go with this method also. Let's say 10 hundreds are, 10 tens are, okay, 10 ones are. So 10 into 10 into 10. So 10 into 10 into 10, 10 you can write it as 2 into 5. Again, second 10 you can write it as 2 into 5, third 10 you can write it as 2 into 5. Not only 1000, if you find any number which is bigger and you are finding it difficult to write in one line, you can go with this method also to find the prime factor. So here directly I can write 2 cube into 5 cube. So 3 plus 1 is 4, 3 plus 1 is 4. The power I am adding 1 and multiplying it. What is the answer? 4 into 4 is 16. Is my answer is 16? No. Careful with the statement which they have given. They said excluding 1000 means we have to exclude the maximum factor or one factor out of it. So this is 16, which is total number of factor, minus 1, 15. So you have to be very careful when you are reading the question. Before marking, just make sure what question is asking and what the answer you have to find out. Okay. So answer here is 15. So again, the same technique I followed and I got the answer for 1000 also. 1000 is again a big number and you can solve it in less time. If you are perfect with this technique, you can do this calculation mentally and get the answer directly. Okay, so that's why practice a lot so that it will be easy for you to solve these kind of questions in very less time. Now, let me tell you one more type of question which you can get in this. So what they can ask is, let's say I'll go back to this slide. So 200 is there, no? So they might ask how many factors of 200 are ending with 0. How many factors of 200 are ending with 0? They might even ask this way also. Don't worry, in that case also it is the same. What is the prime factor of 200 here? 2 cube into 5 square. So here what you have to do is, you should not add 1 to the power of 2 and power of 5. Okay, so you just have to multiply the given power only, that is 3 into 2. So 3 into 2 is 6. 6 is the number of factor which are ending with 0 for 200. So original number of factors are 12, which we already calculated, but this time we wanted the factor which is ending with 0. So whenever they are asking you to find out the factor which are ending with 0, what you have to do is you should not add 1 to the power of 2 and power of 5. For example, one more example here for 300 also, if I want to find out the factors ending with 0, what is 300 ka power prime factor? 2 square, 3 to the power of 1 and 5 square. So I told you already, if they are asking ending with 0, don't add 1 to the power of 2 and power of 5. So write it as it is. So that's why I am writing 2 to the power of 2 as it is. Now you might be wondering, do we have to add for 3? Yes, we have to add for 3 as it is, except for 2 and 5, rest all the factors you can add it. Just 2 and 5 you should not add it. Okay, so 3 I am adding as usual, 1 plus 1, 2, and 5 I am not adding. So what will be my answer here? 2 into 2 into 2, 8. There are 8 factors which are ending with 0 are the factors of 300. So clear, this is one more twist, or they can make complicated by asking this way, that is number of factor which are ending with 0. That time remember, don't add the power 1 to the power of 2 and power of 5. That's it. Okay, so rest all you can add it 1. Otherwise, if they are asking total number of factors, then you should add 1 to all the powers. Only in the case of ending with 0, don't add to the power of 2 and 5 that 1. Okay, got it? So let me summarize what we have discussed. It's very simple technique, finding the number of factors. So what we have to do is convert the given number into prime factor form. Once you convert into prime factor form, take the power and add 1. Once you get that result, just multiply the result, you will get the answer. Okay. So if you are finding a number which are ending with 0, just for 2 and 5, the base 2 and 5, the factors 2 and 5, you should not add 1. Rest all the factor, you can add it as usual, 1, and get your answer. Got it? So let's see, for 1000, tell me for 1000 how many factors are there which are ending with 0. How many factors of 1000 we have which are ending with 0. So what you will do? So we already have 2 cube into 5 cube. I told you, if I am asking ending with 0, I should not add 1 to the power of 2 and to the power of 5. So I should multiply as it is. So 3 into 3, 9. 9 numbers or 9 factors are there which are ending with 0, which divides 1000, are the factors of 1000. So originally there were 16 factors. So now we have 9 because we were asking ending with 0 factors. Got it? So it's very simple. Please practice so that you can understand the method, and please practice getting the prime factors also. I told you prime factor is the factor which is a prime number. Got it? Okay. I hope this video is helpful. Please stay tuned to our online Tayari channel, and please like, comment, share and subscribe to our channel to know more about these kind of techniques. All the best.